Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. We're going to be talking about religion today, so buckle up. It's going to be a good one. What's going on, guys? Thanks for checking into my channel today. If you don't know who I am, my name's Aaron C., and I actually run this channel in order to help others on their journey to their authentic selves and also to educate other people on what it's like to be trans in today's society. So if that sounds like something that might be helpful to you, consider boom, subscribing, and I hope you find this helpful. Okay, so I've kind of been working on this one for a little while. I've been wanting to make this video since the start of my YouTube channel, and I have not felt like I was in a place to where I can explain it in a way to where you would be able to understand. So this is just my opinion. You know, everything in this is just my opinion, how I view the world. It's, you know, in my experience, this is how I feel. So in the course of a few weeks, I had multiple signs pointing me to sit down and write this video. This one's a big one for me because I've grown up in the church and I have a very complicated relationship with the church as a whole, right? The experience with the church, and many LGBTQ people do, and they do rightfully so. And I have an emotionally heavy relationship with God. That's kind of why I've procrastinated this video up to this point. So hopefully we can clear up some things and we can have some good, like, positive discussion about religion and, God and, you know, how we are able to blend that with being trans. So shout out to these awesome subscribers that requested this video. I thought it wouldn't be able to fit in kind of like an FAQ video without having its own video to kind of preface it in a way. So since Emmy would love to see a video about being trans and Christian, and another subscriber, Busisi Way, since they were asking how I was able to reconcile my faith with my gender identity and still identify as a Christian, I think it's time to talk about it. I'd like to preface this answer with the fact that these are my opinions, right? I'm not someone who's going to shove my religion or my beliefs on other people, and your relationship with God, or lack thereof, isn't my business. I believe it's between you and Him, and I'm very passionate about what I believe and what I believe why I do. I do not believe you're less than me or going straight to hell if your feelings are different than mine. I love you for you, and that's my job here on earth, and my opinion is to love you for you. Just to be sure I answer the question, first and foremost, I can reconcile my faith because it's no longer a battle. It's about God and what He did for me in my life. He bailed me out as a young child, and He helped me rise from the ashes of trauma. In my opinion, I don't have the strength to kind of stand up against that, stand up from that pain, from that hurt. And some days I still believe I don't have the strength to dust myself off. But, I believe that in every step, in every hurdle, hill, mountain, hurricane that I went through in my childhood, God strategically placed me in those places. And He strategically placed people in my life to guide me through that. Christianity is literally defined as the religion based on the person and teachings of Jesus of Nazareth. And I follow Jesus, the red words of the Bible. If you ask me how I reconciled my faith, I would be lying to you if I told you that I worked through it and just kind of got it done, right? Because I was less than 6 years old when He began rescuing me. As I got older, my relationship with God throughout my middle school years was absolutely treacherous. I was trying my best to follow all these rules that this precious Bible had mapped out for me that I learned about in my earlier childhood years, but it was different this time. In middle school, I had my first love, and I was scared to even hold hands with her in fear of God's wrath. I would write F-R-O-G on my wrist whenever I felt myself missing her or thinking of any girl in that way. I would pray. God brought me through all these horrible things growing up, and this bond and this peace that I had learned to grow close with as a child, He was my saving grace. I knew that God had to love me and to help me out of those hard situations. And now here I was, 10 years later in middle school, beating myself up for things that I had no control over. After beating myself up for years, I realized God wouldn't want me hating myself anymore. God wouldn't want us putting ourselves down every single day and hating ourselves because of this feeling that we have that we cannot deny. I know for a fact that I can't deny it because I did try, and it got exhausting, and it destroyed my relationship with God and momentarily with the church. Just hanging in there, just having this facade that on the outside I'm straight and I'm going to church 3 days a week with my family, and we are this cookie cutter, church going you know, group, and then you've got softball practice where you're putting on the same exact show for everybody with this like dirty little secret in your heart that you feel that you shouldn't be feeling at all, and it's just constantly surfacing up and you're getting teased. And I mean, there's just so many things that were going on in my life in my middle school years and the beginning of my high school years that I just could not have survived without God. Honestly, my memory is very fragmented if you ask me about my life before graduating high school. But I can tell you who I was close with that helped me through each and every one of those hard times that I faced. As kids, my Nana was there for me and my siblings no matter what to make sure it got done, it being whatever we needed as children. A few close friends in school are the ones that deserve the credit for saving me in high school and middle school without even really knowing what they were doing. And I couldn't have survived without God putting those people strategically in my life in each step to help make sure that I got to where I am today. In my opinion, reconciling your faith is realizing that most people are breaking the commandment by ridiculing you. Without even realizing it, they're preaching with hearts full of vain and attempting to try and speak for God. You may stand for the Bible and a specifically translated version of a verse, but you do not verbally assault other people with your belief of any topic, because honestly, that's just human decency. Use the Lord's name in vain isn't what we learned growing up either. It's not about how many times you say, "Oh my God, here we go again," or "Oh my God, seriously," or "For God's sakes." It's not about that. It's about using God's name to justify your own prejudice and your own hatred for other people. The true meaning of using the Lord's name in vain is using the Bible to beat up other people with. Hey guys, so actually it looks like my footage ran out. I don't know if my battery stopped or what, but it looks like I lost at the very end of that video. So I just wanted to pop on here and kind of share my final thoughts. It's sad because the Bible, I don't think it should be weaponized. I think it should be used to find inspiration and unconditional love, and we need strength, right? All of these are strong emotions that we as lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, non-binary people aren't used to being able to find these feelings and feel these feelings so easily. I believe the Bible can be a pathway to learn more about God and His power and His unconditional love. It wasn't an easy process, and I'm still always working to improve my relationship with God. I definitely want to read your comments. I want to know how you guys were able to reconcile like your faith with your gender identity, right? It's not something that we hear a lot about. So I hope that answered your question. If you have some input on being trans and being Christian or having faith or religion or lack thereof religion, like if you want to have some positive discussions below, please drop a comment. If you like this video, please consider subscribing. I appreciate you guys. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you all are having a magnificent day at evening here. And I will check you guys in the next video. Peace out.